Hey guys, how's it going? Angus here from Maker's Muse. So, something that's been on my mind for a while is when you think about 3D design, 3D modeling, people often think you need a really powerful computer. It costs lots of money to get started, things like that. And I love free things. I know a lot of people like free things, but I love doing something called dumpster diving, where you go around the streets on throwouts and grab free stuff. And I've been seeing a lot of computer parts recently, and I thought, for a bit of a challenge, could I build a PC capable of running CAD software for nothing? Zilch. So this is going to be the first part of this series, and what I've got here around me, you can't see it because the camera is too crap, but got all the parts that I've salvaged over the last month or so. So I'll sort of go through it. First is this motherboard here. So this is an AMD system. It's a dual core Athlon 64-bit system. It's got a single slot for the graphics card, which is PCIe 16. It's got DDR2 memory, so four slots for that. And I've got a 2 gig DDR2 stick here. But the other board I'm considering is a Intel system. So this is another motherboard that I pulled, and it's an Intel Core Duo system. And I've spec'd both the processors up. I think this is look at it. If I can read it, 6750. So I think I can overclock it. And from what I found out, it's actually about half the power consumption of the AMD dual core. So I might end up going with the Intel system. In terms of storage, haven't come across any hard drives because, fair enough, people aren't going to throw away hard drives with all their data on it, although I have come across laptops with data on it. That's another story. So I've got this 1 terabyte drive here, which I also got for free because it's from a RAID system and it was a suspect drive. So it still works, but it might have been possibly about to fail. So for a system I'm building like this, I don't really care if it fails. So 1 terabyte, $0. So got that drive here. A DVD drive, again, this is from the AMD system that I found. I assume it still works. Again, all these parts, they may or may not work. I haven't tested them yet. I just have pulled them out of the cases. Cases as well, I've got more out the back. They're pretty crap. So I'm just going to do sort of a bench test and assemble this on a bench and then put it into a case later on. So I'm going to keep looking on the street for better cases. But the ones that I found these parts in were pretty bad. Power supplies. So I've got two to choose from that I found. This one is 350 watts, so pretty gutless. Some brand I have never heard of, so I'm probably not going to go with that. Instead, I may go with this one, Cooler Master. This is a decent power supply, rated for 500 watts, so that's pretty decent. So I'll probably end up going with this one. Looks really good. It's actually quite clean inside, there's not much dust. Believe it or not, I found a graphics card as well. Just in the street. It was actually in the AMD system. This is a 512 meg card, so it's actually not that bad. And it is a EN86000 GT. Quite decent. Only gets its power through the motherboard, so there's no external power connectors or anything. So it should be fairly efficient. If the graphics card doesn't work out, this is kind of cheating. But I also have a GTX 460, which I got for free, but it wasn't from the street. It was from a friend's system that he upgraded and didn't want it anymore. So I'll see how the graphics card goes. The 86000 one, that one. See how that goes, but I might give this one a shot as well to see if it makes much difference. But it will need an external power connection. Yes, two 6 pins. So that's going to be quite power hungry. I don't know if the power supplies will cope. But yeah, so they're the parts I've got, and what I'm going to be looking at doing is assembling a test rig. I'm going to be using Linux, of course, because it's free, so Ubuntu probably. And I'm going to also look at using Wine to try to run some Windows applications, because with 3D design, CAD, that sort of thing, there's not too much available for Linux. There's a few Linux sort of free CAD and stuff, but I want to try running like the Up software, for example. I want to run my Up Mini, so that has to be Windows if this. It doesn't work on Linux, so I'm gonna try using Wine to bridge the gap and see how that goes. But it's all a bit of an experiment. I love doing this sort of stuff, and again, all these parts were completely free, so win. So thanks for watching, guys, and looking forward to the second episode where I'll be something, a test bench, let you know how it goes. And yeah, I just want to encourage you guys to actually like do stuff like this. Like, there's no reason you can't have a get a start into CAD and hacking and making, because people chuck this stuff out and it's ridiculous. One last thing I forgot completely is monitors. So I'm gonna do this entire system for free. I'm not gonna buy anything, and that includes getting the monitor for free. LCD, completely free. I've tested it, works. I've got six of these. I'm not even kidding. Six LCDs that I've tested, they work, and they're quite decent. They're 1024 by 768 resolution. They look good, and they're gonna be perfect for this. So I might even get two screens on my dumpster PC. So we'll see how it goes. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Looking forward to seeing you again here on Make This Muse soon. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel already, I usually do sort of 3D printing tips and tricks, and this is sort of a new area for me, but I'm looking forward to sort of showing people how easy it is to get into 3D printing and 3D design. So thanks for watching, guys. See you again here soon on Maker's Muse. Bye.